Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Have you ever thought the corner of your mouth is drooping down? So the angle of the mouth, the oral commissure, people call it the marionette, the malolabial fold. There's many ways to describe it, but people often just come in and say, I have a resting face that I don't like. People say I'm angry when I'm not, or they just come in and grab the skin here and say, I don't like that. And so it's a problem for, we get people coming in their 20s who actually sometimes don't have a problem. And then we get people coming in when they need a facelift, when we can't do minimally invasive treatments to make it better. So you see the whole range. As always, the sooner people come in and we talk about it, start prevention, maybe do some minimal treatments, the better. Because at a certain point, surgery is the only thing. Today I want to talk about some of the treatments, but also focus on what do we do with devices. With fillers, which is one of the staples that people use to treat this area, I don't particularly like them. I might use a vial or two in a bolus technique so that we lift the edge of the mouth, add a bit of neuromodulator, PDO threads with barbs to help lift, filling the preauricular area, doing Plasmasculpt. That whole combination is amazing. But remember, the Plasmasculpt doesn't add a lot of volume, but the filler does. But sometimes we want to subtract. So we don't want to add a lot down here. How do we take away? So we talk about Kybella. That's one way to kill the fat cells. Today, I want to talk about radio frequency. We had a question. They asked, hey, what devices and how would that even work? Radio frequency works by heating the skin. And what we do, I like bipolar radio frequency because it heats, it shrinks the fat cells, but at the same time, we get building of collagen, thickening of the skin, and tightening. So while adding things in this area can look good, reducing by removing fat cells, shrinking them, and tightening the skin adds a very important factor to our fillers, to our threads, and to our Kybella or phosphatidylcholine combinations. Now, I want to talk about five things regarding radio frequency that we should be aware of. Number one, it works very well, and there is a slight instant result, but we're looking at the results over time. So it makes the fat cells a little leaky, they shrink, and over time, you get reduction in that area at the same time as collagen building. So the result, while it can be instant, we're looking for a longer term result. So the result is not instant, but really occurring over time. Number two, it's minimally invasive. So while it's comfortable, you need several treatments. It's part of a culture. And outside of the United States, it's very normal for people to come in for multiple treatments, and it's becoming that way here. But we need to understand these are treatments that we do over time, maybe every month or two for the complete year cycle. So it's part of a bigger program. Number three, as with all of these treatments, it's not one or the other, but it's a combination. So combining radio frequency with all of our other treatments yields the best results. So when you go to a clinic and they recommend something, but also some filler, some Kybella, some threads, they're not trying to upsell you into anything. They're trying to give you the best result to look as natural as you can be. Number four, I mentioned bipolar radio frequency because it tightens, helps shrink the fat cells, multiple frequencies within there. So being able to get to multiple depths. So if you can alter the depth of your device so it's tunable, it allows you to go to the deeper fat, the more superficial fat, and then of course, dermal thickening, collagen building, and tightening. So it is a very device-dependent procedure. And then down to number five, it's dependent upon the user. As you might expect, it's an interesting part of the culture. They say, oh, I had this procedure done and it didn't work for me. Whether it's filler, neuromodulator, threads, or devices. It's not the device that did the work, it's partly the device, but a good percentage of the result is coming from the technician, the injector, the doctor, the nurse, whoever did the procedure. So while it's important to have the right device and something that's tunable so we can heat the skin to the right depths, to the right temperature, because it's all about heating without burning, It's also dependent on who's doing the procedure and the communication of the patient or client to the person doing the procedure to let them know how they're feeling, how the heat is and how much they can take, and the number of pulses that somebody gets. So there's many factors that determine it, but radio frequency works very well. We use a bipolar device with suction that we can change the depths. It's what I use in my practice. If you have questions below or you've had other procedures, let us know. What have you liked? What's worked for you? And what are the best combination procedures? Join us on Instagram. Also here on this YouTube channel, subscribe for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.